Welcome to Ventura Video Voter 2010. I'm David Marin. Today we're interviewing Congresswoman Lois Capps, representing the 23rd District. Lois, welcome to our show.
I'm happy to be here with you, David.
Lois, we have some questions. We'd like to learn from you what you think is the biggest national issue affecting the people in your district.
It's clearly the fact that we have a slowly rebounding economy, and the jobs are not coming as quickly as we wanted them to. And I'm very engaged in doing all that I can from my position as the representative to the U.S. House of Representatives to represent my constituents and find ways of increasing our employment here.
Well, I think that's right, the jobs mantra that we hear.
Absolutely.
What are some of the things you can do to help stimulate our economy?
There are several, and we've been working on them in this Congress, and we now have the possibility of another bill that the president is eager to sign into law, which will make it easier for small businesses to borrow money to expand and grow their businesses, making it possible for community banks to loan to small businesses. Keeping taxes low on families and businesses is a key thing, on working families. And I support the Obama tax cuts. I support the efforts to stimulate our small businesses to make it easier for them to grow and develop in this climate. Our nation is built on small businesses. It drives our economy. Our Central Coast is the same.
I see. Before we go on to more issues, I'd like to take a different tack. Right now and for a long time, the view of Congress has been historically low, the opinion of the Congress people from both sides. What do you think that's from, and what can be done about it?
It is troubling. My background is being a nurse, and that profession is highly regarded. And we are working hard on bringing all the skills that I had as a nurse to bear in my work in Congress, and yet I know people are frustrated because we're in this recession, as I described with the job losses. People are finding it hard to refinance their mortgages. That frustration turns into anger, and there we are, and we make the laws, and we have not been as nimble at responding, in my opinion, as perhaps the people have wanted us to do. We didn't anticipate this coming because the folks responsible kind of withheld the information that the banks were failing and that we were about to plunge into such a huge fiscal challenge.
Are there any other concrete ideas about how to restore that confidence?
We have been investing. We've been investing with federal dollars because we used a huge piece of legislation called the Recovery Act to put money into our local communities, like the Rice Avenue interchange right here in Ventura County, completing that project with recovery dollars that had been many years in the making, which will help our local economy, making it easier for people to get to work, for goods to be transported. That's an example of how we can use federal dollars now to stimulate the economy. Also, we are investing in a couple of areas that are very critical to our future. One is in education. Sent out a state aid recently that I made a special trip back to Washington, D.C. so that we could put more teachers in classrooms at our elementary, secondary level. Now, what does that have to do with the economy? Well, those teachers have jobs, but that's our future workforce. And when we can train these people, these young people, into the future, which includes renewable energy, that is going to drive our economy well into this century.
Well, let's stay with education for just a moment. Is there some more work you can do to bring dollars to the district? We know the schools are just desperately short of funds.
Particularly because California's got its own budget woes, and most of the funding for education comes from there. But we have done a lot to make it more affordable, for example, for young people to go to college. I know that it's a big barrier as college costs have gone up, and many people are finding it tough now in a recession. So we've increased Pell Grants, for example, the loans that you can get to go to college, many-fold, so that they will be up as much as $6,000 in a few years. We've also made it more affordable to get a loan, taking the middleman, the private sector that was making a lot of money from students on the interest rates they were charging. Now the loans come directly from the federal government, which is a huge investment to college education.
Well, let's change gears, talk about another hot topic, immigration. There's a wide range of views on this, the border, illegal immigrants. What's your perspective? What can be done? What will you be working on?
You know, this is a nation of immigrants. I don't know, if, unless you're a native, anyone who's watching this show, their forebears came as immigrants. So our strength as a country is as immigrants. We also have a huge border challenge because it's a porous border, particularly our southern one. Well, the one to Canada is as well. But the concern about people coming without documentation is mostly coming from the border here between California and Mexico. And so keeping that border secure is very important. It's critical for our national security. It's also important that people who come here have proper documentation for their own well-being and safety. So securing the borders, also it's important that we have a workforce in our agriculture-based economy here on the Central Coast. I'm a big supporter of ag jobs. I'm also tremendously interested in the DREAM Act, which young people very much want, who have come here with not their choice, because their parents brought them. They worked their way through education at the elementary, secondary level, and then, because they don't have documentation, they don't have the same access to college. So it may be that within the next few days, when we go back to Congress, we will be passing what is called the DREAM Act, which will make it easier for people to go to college if they can document that they have been very successful in their elementary, secondary education. I'm a big proponent of that piece. But finally, and I know I've belabored this, I feel very strongly that we need to have comprehensive immigration reform. All of the pieces that I've outlined fit into one package. I know we can pass the legislation. It becomes very political at a campaign time. I'm eager for us to do it as soon as we can.
Okay, you mentioned about your district, the agricultural, but there's also industry, there's both
yes.
urban and also rural developments. What kind of work can you do to sort of protect the environment, keep much of the quality of life, but yet also help industry to bring about more jobs?
You know, that's a very wonderful segue into something that I'm quite passionate about, which is the fact that we have wonderful research institutions here. Channel Island State University here in Ventura County. We have Cal Poly way up in San Luis Obispo County, still in my district. And we have UC Santa Barbara. We have a string of community colleges that provide technical support. We have tremendous interest, again, hearkening to my previous theme of energy and renewable energy. I'm part of a group that very much wants to make this a green zone, an area along the Central Coast where we can really partner the federal government with the kind of stimulus that we can give to local businesses and help them to grow in the area of improving our economy along renewable energy lines.
Do you have any examples of doing that?
Well, you know, there's wonderful leadership here in Ventura County. Limonera is an agriculture, lemon and avocado maybe,
producer.
And they are very far-sighted in realizing that they can take some of their lemon orchard and convert it to solar energy as a product in much the same way that you would think of a crop, because they are able to meet their own agricultural needs using solar energy that they've planted, and then they can sell it back to the grid, providing energy for other businesses. There's other agromen. We have many, many industries. I visited Gill's Onions, a wonderful example of a totally self-sufficient industry here in Ventura County, where they take onions and they don't let any piece of it go to waste. Some of your viewers have probably know about it, or maybe they work there. Procter and Gamble is installing solar panels.
So you're continuing to support those organizations?
Oh my goodness, I am so impressed with their ability to take some tax incentives from the federal government, multiply that effort, end up saving, creating more profit for themselves, saving energy, keeping us more self-sufficient, on and on and on, David.
Wow, that's wonderful. Thank you very much for being our guest today and sharing your views. This has been Ventura Video Voter 2010. We've been listening to Lois Capps, the Congresswoman representing District 23. I'm David Marin, reminding you, please vote November 2nd.